edge. So as we saw in our last video, an introduction to this food chemistry, and we also saw that we will be dealing this subject in a series of lecture videos. So today in this video, we are going to start with the part one of carbohydrates, covering the monosaccharides, glucose and fructose. So glucose is an aldose sugar with the molecular formula C6H12O6, and it is the major free sugar circulating in blood. It is also the product of photosynthesis in plants. So photosynthesis is a process by which the plants prepare their own food in the presence of sunlight and carbon dioxide, providing oxygen and energy. And this energy is in the form of glucose. So it is stored as starch in plants. So starch is another polysaccharide that is made up of a complex chain of glucose units linked together. So in the animals, the energy metabolism converts glucose to ATP molecule. So ATP is the adenosine triphosphate molecule, which is the major energy provider for these animals. So it is stored as glycogen in animals. So not all glucose is converted to glycogen. The glucose that is needed for the conversion of energy is used up, and the excess or the remaining glucose in the bloodstream is converted to glycogen, and it is stored in the liver of the animal. So in animals, glucose is released from the breakdown of glycogen in process known as glycogenolysis, which also takes place in the liver. So whenever there is a need for glucose, and when diet doesn't provide enough glucose to the organism, again the glycogen is broken down to glucose molecule through this glycogenolysis process. So glucose is also used to build the cell wall in animals, and cell wall's main constituent is cellulose. So cellulose is also a complex polysaccharide consisting of a chain of glucose units linked together. So glucose is a naturally occurring sugar, and it is found in fruits and other parts of plants in its free state. So moving on to the next, glucose is the building block of disaccharide, lactose and sucrose, and also for the oligosaccharides such as raffinose and the polysaccharides such as starch or amylopectin, glycogen or cellulose. So the glass transition temperature of glucose is 31 degrees Celsius. So what is this glass transition temperature? The temperature required for a food material to undergo a phase change from a glassy amorphous to a rubbery state is what we call the glass transition temperature. So the glucose can exist in an open chain, vertical, straight chain or fissure projection, and all these structures comes as an acyclic structure, and as well as the ring form which comes under the cyclic structure. So the right top image depicts the acyclic or the straight chain vertical structure of glucose, whereas the bottom image represents the ring or the cyclic structure. So dextrose is the name of a simple sugar that is made from corn and is chemically very much identical to D-glucose or the blood sugar. So dextrose is often used in the baking products as sweeteners, and it can be found in items such as processed food, corn syrup, etc. So the commercial name or the industrial term for glucose is also referred to as dextrose. So moving on to the next, fructose. So fructose is a keto sugar with the same molecular formula as glucose, that is C6H12O6. So the other names include levulose or the D-arabinohexulose. So the fructose is found in honey, tree and vine fruits, flowers, berries and most root vegetables. And also 55% of high fructose corn syrup is fructose. So unlike glucose, fructose is not directly converted to energy in the human body. Instead, it is broken down into easily absorbable components. Like less than 1% is converted to plasma triglyceride, whereas 29 to 54% is converted to glucose in the liver, and about quarter of the fructose is converted to lactate, and 15% to 18% is again converted to glycogen. So among this, the glucose and the lactate are the energy providers to fuel the cells all over the body of an animal. So like glucose, fructose also exhibits both cyclic and acyclic structure, which is represented here. So moving on to the next, we will see about the structural classification of this aldose and keto sugars. So the aldose sugars, and for example, glucose, has the C1 as the aldehydic group, that is the functional group, is present on the top and the representing the first carbon atom, and the primary hydroxyl group, that is the C6, is present at the last of that is the end of the molecule. So the between molecules, that is the C2, C3, C4 and C5, represents the secondary hydroxyl group. So this secondary hydroxyl group plays a very important role in exhibiting isomerization phenomenon. So moving on to the next, for the ketose group, the C1 and C6 represents the primary hydroxyl group, whereas the functional group is present at the C2 position. And the secondary hydroxyl groups are at C3, C4 and C5 position. So there are only three secondary hydroxyl groups for a hexose keto sugar. And there are four secondary hydroxyl groups for a hexose aldose sugar. So moving on to the next, D and L sugars. So the D sugars are also known as dextrorotatory sugars, rotates the plane polarized light in the clockwise direction, and it is indicated by the sign plus or with the prefix D. And the L sugars or the levorotatory sugars rotates the plane polarized light in the counterclockwise or anticlockwise direction, and it is indicated by the sign minus or with the prefix L. So chirality is one of the important phenomenon exhibited by these sugars. So when four different groups are attached to the same carbon atom, then that carbon atom is called as chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon. So moving on to the previous slide to see an example, you can see the D glucose, where the C2, C3, C4 and C5, the secondary hydroxyl groups, have four different groups attached to the carbon atoms. For example, let us take C2. You can see one of the bond is attached to the aldehyde group, whereas the other to a OH group, and the other to the rest of the chain, and the other bond is for the hydrogen. And similar pattern is observed in C2, C3, C4 and C5 carbon, whereas C6, you can see two bonds have the same group attached to it, that is the hydrogen. So this cannot be chiral, whereas the secondary hydroxyl groups have four different groups attached to it. So it is called chiral carbon atoms. So it is the same for this keto sugar also, that the C3, C4 and C5 secondary hydroxyl groups are called chiral atoms because they have four different groups attached to the four bonds of the carbon atom. So moving on to the next. So the carbon atom can exist in two spatial arrangements. So the sugars exhibiting this chirality phenomenon can exhibit in two spatial different spatial arrangements, and this two different spatial arrangements are the D and L arrangements. So this D and L arrangements are exact mirror images of each other, and they are also non-superimposable mirror images. That is, when the D sugars or the L sugars are placed one upon the other, they are non-superimposable, meaning they do not merge or they are not the same in the spatial arrangement. So the D sugars and L sugars are isomers of each other, and also they are the mirror images of each other. So these sugars are naturally occurring and L sugars are synthetic, and they are very less abundant in nature. So there are two food sugars like the L arabinose and L galactose, which are present as units in the carbohydrate polymer present in the cell wall. So moving on to the next. So the secondary hydroxyl groups plays an important role in determining the chirality of the atoms. Since each chiral atom has a mirror image, there are two N arrangements for those atoms, and this N represents the number of chiral atoms in the sugar. So let us consider the hexose as an example. So hexoaldoses and hexoketoses, where you can see hexoaldoses have four chiral atoms. So you take it as 2 power N or 2 power 4, that is equal to 16 different arrangements of these hexoaldoses sugars. So in this 16, it will be divided as 8 D sugars and 8 L sugars. So if you have seen our previous introductory video, I would have discussed the Rosanoff structure of the D-aldoses sugars. So if you have not watched that video, I will drop the video link below in the description box. So please do watch it. So in that you can see that hexoses are 8 sugars, that is the allose, altrose, glucose, mannose, gulose, idose, galactose and tallose. So this 8 sugars exhibit 2 different forms. So 8 into 2, you get 16 different forms of sugars. So 2 different forms are the D and L forms. So this is used to identify the number of forms that a sugar can exhibit. So when it comes for a pentose, for example, 5-carbon aldose sugar, you will get as 2^3. Okay, 2^3 is 8. So there are totally 4 pentose sugars. If you see the Rosanoff structure, you will get to know. So 4 pentose sugar, and those pentose sugars exhibited 2 different forms. That is the D form and its mirror image, the L form, forming totally 8 types of arrangements. So the similar is seen for a 6-carbon, that is a hexose keto sugar like the fructose, which has 3 chiral atoms. So 2^3, you get 8. So totally there are 4 types of hexo-keto sugar, that is piscose, fructose, sorbose and tagatose. So when these 4 sugars exhibit 2 different forms, that is the D form and the L form, you totally get 8 different types of arrangements of this carbon atom. So that is all we are discussing about an introduction to the straight chain structure of the monosaccharides. So in the upcoming sessions, we will be discussing about the monosaccharide ring formation, isomerization, and various chemical reactions. So until then, keep watching, stay tuned, and know and learn more about food technology. Thank you.